Hi, I'm Shenelle.
And I'm Gennelle, and this is Shenelle and Gennelle, where book talk meets culture.
Where our mission is to share books that are accessible, culturally relevant, and engaging to help support struggling or reluctant readers.
Yes. So today we have another book, and it's called My Rolls and Piles of Coins. So this inspirational book is about a young boy who is saving money to buy a bicycle. Now here's the thing, the bicycle is not just for him to ride around and to enjoy, but to help his mother carry heavy loads to and from the market.
Yes.
So what makes this book a little inspirational is that this young boy does not even know how to ride a bike. But he's planning, this is his dream, is to get a bike to help his mother in the market.
Yeah, and I think that this book speaks a lot to like determination and perseverance, but just to go back more into like the background of the book, the boy helps his mother during the day in the market, and this book takes place in Tanzania. So it's not a US-based book, it's a book that happens in another country. So it's not like the traditional sense where, oh, I'm just going to go to the store for my mom. This is a lifestyle and culture for him. This is why it's so relevant and important that he gets this bike. Mm-hmm. So his mom gives him a few earnings every time he helps out the market. And this is what the boy secretly does. He saves the money in anticipation to buy the bike, but he doesn't really let his family know that quite yet in the story.
In the story, yeah. So that's what makes it very inspirational. Yeah. I like that the book, because this is a kind of a surprise for the boy, I just think as you go out through the book, you learn of the boy's character, his determination, his perseverance, right? To actually save money, to do something, not for yourself, but to give to someone else.
Yes.
And I always like books that are inspiring like that.
Yeah, and I think that kids can relate to this, or parents can actually make this connection with their kids on the importance of like seeing someone else's needs and taking the initiative to do something about it without being asked or, you know, just being told or just wanting from yourself. So he didn't really want a bike, but there was a more intention and motivation behind him getting the bike.
Yeah.
So the book really goes through whether or not he's going to actually get enough money
to buy the bike. So there's obstacles that he has to overcome, and it's a little twist and turn to the end, but those are basically the general themes and ideas that are fostered throughout the book.
Yeah. So let's discuss whether or not this book is ace, because I thought it was a little different.
Okay.
In general. So when it comes to accessibility, this book for me, I feel like is not so much accessible for struggling readers. There are some words in there that's in Swahili and some vocabulary words that maybe need some support with. But the overall sentence structure and the way that the story tells, it could be with some support. I do think so.
Yeah, I agree. I think that the vocabulary is not very high, but it's a tad high, and the structure of it is a little more challenging. But I do think I would view this book as an opportunity to learn something different, an opportunity to learn some new words, an opportunity to read a text that's a little more challenging, because there is pictures in there that can help you aid with some of the meaning and what's going on. But I do think a lot of prior knowledge has to be undertaken, or you have to review a lot of that before beginning reading this book.
A lot of pre-teaching before doing this book. I don't think picking up this book and going right away. I mean, if you just want kids to sit there and just listen to read aloud, then maybe, but even then, like, you have to still stop and discuss things to make some cultural connections and
all
that. Yeah,
definitely. Culturally relevant?
Culturally relevant.
Another interesting one here for culturally relevant. So this did not take place in the United States. So if you're reading this to kids in the United States, the concept of the market might be so far and in between. And I think this is important to point out, because I think a lot of times when we think about selecting books that are culturally relevant or using black characters, this is definitely a black character book. Mm-hmm. And it is speaking about a culture, but the culture is not reflective of what we see in the U.S. Kids typically do not work in a market in the U.S. So I think that not that the book cannot be culturally engaging in sense, but I think you have to be very careful with just saying that, oh, the kids will be able to relate to this. They may be able to make some connections, like maybe they've been to a farmer's market and they can actually see pictures of things that it looks like. But kids typically do not relate to selling fruits or vegetables in a market traditionally the way this is done in this book.
Yeah. The reason why I like this book, though, because it could connect to kids that maybe were immigrants and came over the country, that came over to the U.S. that have this experience. So I won't say this is a book not to use, but it also gives children in the U.S. a way to see what how other children in the world live. And I think that's where we need to make the connection. Mm-hmm. So I think it would be an error to think, I'm going to pick up this book because there's a brown boy on the cover and these kids are black and we're going to make the connections. I think that would be going an error because culturally, it's not really relevant. But if you want to teach about a lifestyle or a culture outside of what we experience here, this is a good book because it shows like what he's doing on daily life. And then it also has some similar themes that kids in the U.S. also have, like determination, perseverance, resilience, you know. So
yeah, so that's what I was about to say. I was going to say a takeaway from this book, a connection you can make, is that he perseveres, he's resilient, he saves. So those are things that you can talk about in terms of how do you save? Have you ever had a desire to have a bike before? When did you learn to ride a bike? And I think that's one of the things, this young boy, the idea that he wanted to help someone do something even though he didn't have it himself. So his dream was to help someone, but he had no skills in riding a bike. So it was like, have you ever wanted to help someone but didn't know how to begin? Like, I think kids can make connections in that sense.
Yeah.
So I think that's what I like about it. I like the themes that were
in the book. There's a lot of discussion points. Engaging. I thought this book was engaging because I was like, would this little boy ever get the bike? He faces so many obstacles. And then to know that he has a dream to attain something that he doesn't even have the skills to really use at the moment. He doesn't own a bike. He doesn't know how to ride a bike, but yet he's saving for a bike. And then when he tries to get the bike, it's like, is he ever going to have enough money for the bike? Mm-hmm. There's just so many things that's going on. So I think the author did a good job in having the readers try to root for the character like throughout the book. So it keeps you engaged. Like, okay, what's going to happen next?
Yeah, what's going to happen next?
Is he ever going to get this bike?
Yeah, and as a read along, you could stop and ask those questions. Oh my gosh, another problem? Yeah, so I do like that. I think overall the themes and what makes this book beautiful is the idea that you're doing something for someone else. This is generosity beyond yourself. This is saving your money, not to get a prize that you may want, but to get something that would benefit the life of someone else. And I think overall, that's the beauty of this story and in this book.
So would he ever get the bike? You guys got to get a copy to find out.
So long story short, we're going to say that we think this book is accessible. It has some cultural themes that we can relate to, but doesn't really represent the culture in which we live. And it's engaging because we're inspired by the boy's story and his determination to pursue a dream that he right now does not have any skills for. So overall, we're going to say we're going to give this book an A and an E for accessible and engagement. But definitely get your copy and you determine for yourself. Till next time.
Bye.